At the onset, while I extend my warm greetings to institutional leaders, academia, industry leaders, I also take this opportunity to extend my grateful thanks to the Honorable President of India for blessing us with a lasting legacy of engagement, debate, and deliberation through this, the annual platform aptly named the Visitors Conference. I take this opportunity to thank the Honorable Prime Minister, who dared us to dream big and led us to transform that dream into reality. For who would have thought that an idea that germinated from this very conference a year ago would meet with success within a span of just 12 months? A famous jurist once said, "If we lose our sensitivity towards the quality of life, it can only mean that while our knowledge increases, our ignorance does not diminish." The Honorable Prime Minister gave a clarion call that institutions of higher education leverage their research capabilities for socially relevant programs, identify technology gaps, and prepare plans for innovations that could substantially increase income and growth in rural India. Thus, began a journey called Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. While I congratulate institutions that have adopted villages to help accelerate growth through technology transfer, I implore that much more can be done. To complement our engagements with central institutions, while we recognize the need to infuse new knowledge into our academic ecosystem, we also bear in mind the economic challenges many of our students are confronted with when a desire to engage with foreign academicians manifests itself, but the dream dies a painful death in the absence of money. Hence, I thank the Honorable Prime Minister for sharing his vision of enabling foreign academicians to come teach in India at government institutions across the nation at no added cost to our students under a program called Gyan. Starting this November, in the coming 1 year, we, under Gyan, will welcome 400 foreign academicians in government institutions to impart new knowledge to our students and share new teaching methodologies with our faculty. Gough once said, "Whatever you can do or dream you can, begin it." And begin we did. We translated the vision of the Honorable Prime Minister and dedicated to the nation the first ever national institutional ranking framework in September 2015, which will annually rank all higher educational institutions based on an objective and verifiable criteria, a system which will allow declaration of ranks by the first week of April every year, thereby empowering our students to make informed choices. And while we leverage technology to empower the choices of our students, we also recognize the power of technology to help create more learning opportunities. For a nation is not only built on bricks and mortar, a civilization flourishes on enlightenment. HRD has resolved, with the blessings of the Honorable Prime Minister, to build an Indian MOOCs platform on which we aspire to bring close to 2.5 lakh hours of e-content on a single platform called Swayam, thereby possibly making it the world's largest repository of electronic learning resource under a single window. From school education modules of level 9 to 12 to varied courses in aerospace engineering, biotechnology, atmospheric sciences, languages, Swayam will ensure universal access to high-quality education for every Indian. My sincere thanks to institutions present here today who have confirmed close to 714 courses that will be specially designed for Swayam. Ladies and gentlemen, before I conclude, let me also extend my gratitude to our friends from the industry who have engaged with our academic institutions to give impetus to research, enable and encourage student placements. To them I say, as Nani Palkiwala famously said, "This is the best investment you could have made, for knowledge is the only instrument of production which is not subject to diminishing returns." In the end, while I thank the Honorable Prime Minister for gracing this occasion and the Honorable President for hosting this much-needed conference, I recognize that opportunities multiply when they are seized and die when they are neglected. Without much further ado, I look forward to this historic opportunity to witness the launch of Imprint India with the blessings of the Honorable President and the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Congress Party. टॉलरेंस पर भाषण देने लगी है? अरे डूब मरो आपको शोभा नहीं देता है।